Plagued by substance abuse, prone to butting heads with bandmates, and haunted by family tragedy, it's no wonder that guitarist Dave Navarro has made some enemies in his long and troubled time in the spotlight. Part of the reason Jane's addiction stopped making music is because singer Perry Farrell and guitarist Dave Navarro just couldn't get along. Following the release of 1990's Ritual de lo Habitual, Jane's addiction hit the road. In an oral biography of Perry Farrell and Jane's addiction, Farrell said, "That 13-month tour behind Ritual was half the reason we wound up unable to stand one another. The other half is that I'm an intolerable narcissist who can't get along with anyone." The group was also at odds over substance abuse. At the time, Farrell and drummer Stephen Perkins were actively abusing drugs, while Navarro and bassist Eric Avery were trying to stay sober. Following the Ritual dates, Farrell decided to throw a farewell tour for his band, which evolved into the traveling Lollapalooza festival. On the very first night of Lollapalooza in 1991, Jane's addiction set ended when Farrell and Navarro threw punches at each other on stage, and then Navarro tossed his guitars into the audience so that the show couldn't go on. The pair came to blows during a concert again in September 2024. Farrell, reportedly deeply irritated by poor sound levels and tinnitus, shoved and screamed at Navarro as he played. The guitarist held him back, Farrell tried to land a punch, then Avery subdued Farrell by force while Navarro walked off the stage. That ended the concert, and within a couple of days, the tour was canceled. The Red Hot Chili Peppers ran through multiple guitarists in the 1990s, with Dave Navarro joining in 1993. In 1995, the band released One Hot Minute, a dark and heavy record reflecting Navarro's involvement. The guitarist and the band disassociated in 1998, having made just one album, and when announcing the split, Navarro emphasized that it was so he could spend more time on his other band, Spread, and that there were no hurt feelings involved. In 2018, Navarro admitted that he was nudged out of the band when former and now sober guitarist John Frusciante wanted to return. During the 1997 Jane's Addiction reunion tour, which featured the Chili Peppers' Flea on bass, Navarro relapsed and continued to heavily abuse drugs after the concert run completed. On his Dark Matter radio podcast, he admitted,
"Got really bad. Then I finally showed up for a Chili Peppers rehearsal, and I honestly couldn't play a f***ing note."
After tripping over speakers and toppling into some boxes, Navarro knew the Red Hot Chili Peppers didn't want him anymore.
"Wasn't going to be able to get it together. And so they decided to go a different direction."
In 1983, when Dave Navarro was just 15 years old, his mother, Connie Navarro, was killed in her home by an ex-boyfriend, John Riccardi.
"Have you ever been able to say to this guy, 'Why'd you take my mother from me?'"
No.
After the case was featured on America's Most Wanted, Riccardi was arrested in 1991, convicted of murder, and received the death penalty, later commuted to life in prison. In 2018, Geraldo Rivera made an episode of his show, Geraldo Rivera's Murder in the Family, a true crime series that examines the killings of relatives of famous people, with TV crews revisiting the scene of the murder, about the death of Connie Navarro, completed without the requested permission of Dave Navarro.
"John Dean Riccardi makes tracking Connie Navarro his only ambition, as he stalks her every move."
Dave Navarro, clearly unhappy with this, took to Instagram to write, "I find it really disappointing that Geraldo Rivera's new show would ask me to participate in an episode about the tragedies of my life, and when I say no, they decided to run it anyway with inaccurate facts and total abandon for the triggering effect a program of this nature could have on the families." Referring to the 2015 documentary Morning Sun, in which Navarro explores the events and trauma surrounding his mother's murder, Rivera later told TV Insider, "Dave Navarro has already told his own story, so he wasn't particularly keen to have the story told again. Sometimes it's very difficult for someone who has suffered these traumas to open doors that contain so much pain."